The 8th of January, just a few weeks away, would have been Elvis Presley's 50th birthday. There'll be scores of TV specials, magazine tributes, and music.
You get pregnant if you just relax.
You waited too long, honey.
When you're trying to have a baby and can't, most advice is bad advice. We can help with treatment and support with the American Fertility Society and Resolve. We can bring fertility problems out of the dark.
For more information about local infertility counseling, support groups, and programs, contact Vermont Resolve at 877-3471.
WPTZ, Plattsburgh, North Pole, Burlington.
This week's Focus with William Casey will air next Sunday at 6 p.m.
Look at five, we're bringing the best there is to you. Look at five, proud to be with you. Look at us, we've come a long way. We're bringing it all to you every day. Look at five. Look at WPTZ.
Good evening and welcome to Channel 5's 30th anniversary celebration. Anniversaries are always a good time to reminisce with friends on all the good times had along the way. And that's what we'd like to do with you in the next 30 minutes. We'll have a rare behind-the-scenes look at a show that aired live on Channel 5 back in 1955. You'll also see some old program clips from network and local shows that aired here on Channel 5 during the last 30 years. We'll try to tease your memory with some trivia questions, as well as give you some of the flavor of the past 30 years. It's all part of our anniversary present to you, so sit back in your favorite easy chair, grab some snacks, and enjoy along with us as we celebrate 30 years together, Channel 5 and you.
It's time to lift yourself out of the winter doldrums. Start a hobby in crafts with a little help from the spinning wheel. Stop in today and pick up a schedule of classes offered in quilting, needlework, just about any craft work you can imagine. The spinning wheel also has notions for the hobbyist and is fully stocked in yarns. If you're redecorating your home, the spinning wheel has the largest selection of in-stock fabric north of Albany with a complete decorating service available. Complement your artwork with framing from the spinning wheel's framing shop. Stop in and see designer Ruth Murphy and manager Eleanor Frenier at the spinning wheel in downtown Plattsburgh.
Catherine Grayson, Howard Keel, and Ann Miller star in Cole Porter's musical comedy classic, Kiss Me, Kate.
Oh, kiss me, Kate, for an angel in mine, for now I shall never be mine.
Kiss Me, Kate, this week's Five Star Theater, Sunday at 11 p.m.
Friends, I'd like to introduce you to our very special guest out from the Grand Ole Opry in WSM, Nashville, Tennessee, Mr. Bill Monroe.
One, two, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. Put your bad rags on. Join me, hot. We'll have some fun when the
clock strikes. We start our look back at the last 30 years with the beginning. 1954, the year that gave us the first rock and roll hit ever performed by a group named the Crew Cuts, titled Shaboom. It ended up the number 4 song of the year. The Academy Award Movie of the Year was On the Waterfront, winning Oscars for Marlon Brando as Best Actor, Elia Kazan as Best Director, and Eva Marie Saint as Best Supporting Actress. 3D movies were a dying fad in 54, but others took their place, including Hula Hoops and cramming as many people as possible into a phone booth. By the way, a phone call in 1954 was only 10 cents. Locally, 1954 started out with the dedication of Plattsburgh Air Force Base on January 29th. Present at the groundbreaking was the then mayor of Plattsburgh, John Tyrrell, along with other dignitaries and officials. And by year's end, residents of the North Country were to receive a Christmas present 2 weeks early in the form of their own local television station. On December 8th of 1954, WIRI-TV first signed on the air with the dulcet tones of someone who was then and still is today one of Plattsburgh's most listened to radio announcers.
This is WIRI-TV, North Pole, New York, with studios and offices in Plattsburgh, New York.
Yes, that was the voice of Wiry Radio's Chet Bosworth, who at the time worked for both Wiry Radio and WIRI-TV, which were both owned by a company called Great Northern Television. The call letters of Channel 5 were changed to the present WPTZ in May of 1956, when WIRI-TV was sold to Rollins Incorporated, the present owner. Most of the programs aired on Channel 5 during the first 7 months were locally originated. That meant either showing films or producing our own shows in the studio. One of the very first shows was the Smiley Ouellette Show, a country music program featuring Smiley Ouellette and his band, the Sunset Ramblers. All local shows were done live, as film was too expensive and videotape had not yet been invented. We're fortunate, however, to have some 8mm film and audio tape that was recorded by one of Smiley's band members, Tony Brown. It was shot behind the scenes during a show that featured Bill Monroe, a country music legend from Nashville. Also, during that particular show, a young television announcer was recorded for posterity as he read this live commercial. See if you can identify the voice.
There's no time like the present to modernize that old bathroom. Actually, it's not as big a job as you might think, or as expensive.
In July of 1955, Channel 5 was carrying shows from both the ABC and the NBC network. Some favorites were I Married Joan, in the I Love Lucy tradition. This show centered around the life of another zany wife. She was full of dreams and schemes. The show starred Jim Backus and Joan Davis and was quite a hit for NBC. This first version of the sitcom based on Chick Young's famous cartoon strip starred Pamela Britton as Blondie and Arthur Lake as Dagwood Bumstead, a simple soul just trying to cope with life.
Excuse me, dear.
Hey.
Blondie, ma'am.
Alexander, school dance.
Yeah.
Hey, Alexander!
Ice cream man.
You're too late.
You bet your life, comedian Groucho Marx, of the rapier-like wit and sarcastic asides, was the MC and star of this filmed quiz show.
Julius, I have an Uncle Julius that lives in New York. He thinks he's a vacuum cleaner. It didn't bother us so much when he thought he was an Underwood typewriter, but this worries me. Now, what would you suggest?
Well, actually, this facetious question...
No, it isn't. Sometimes he thinks he's a box of raisins.
It would ordinarily require a facetious answer, Groucho, but actually there are psychiatric situations in which persons who suffer from these schizophrenic delusions in which they...
That's a split personality. Huh?
Yeah, something like that.
I mean, he could go to Chicago and the rest of them could go to St. Paul. And
that's right, in which case you would need a sort of a sectional couch to treat him.
More than any other sitcom in the 50s, Love That Bob showed how we looked at women. And that was it. We looked at them. Only looked. This show starred Bob Cummings as a perennial rover.
Did you tell Kay I was sick? You told everybody else.
I told her. She said she thought it was just another one of your tricks.
Heartless attitude. I could have died here.
Miss Schultz, I thought I recognized your voice.
Look, wait a minute. This whole
Lie thing... down, Mr. Cummings.
Look, I don't want to lie down. If you'll just listen to me for 1 minute. Come in. Might as well have the whole bridge club in here.
Please lie down.
Look, will you listen to me? Mrs. Niemeyer, will you listen to me? I am not sick. I am all right. There's nothing wrong with me. I am fine. This whole thing was just a gag to get the sympathy of a certain young lady. I appreciate very much what you two are trying to do for me, but I'm fine. I'm all right. I'm not sick. I don't...
By the late 50s, Channel 5 had modified its transmitter to color. The TV networks, NBC especially, were producing more and more shows in living color. Although Channel 5 had a color transmitter in 1959, it wasn't until 1971 that we had color studio cameras. In the 1959 TV season, there were 32 westerns on 3 TV networks. NBC aired Wagon Train. The original star was Ward Bond. In 1961, he was replaced by John McIntyre. Another popular Western was The Virginian, the first 90-minute Western ever. The series star was James Drury. When we come back, we'll take a look at the 1960s, a decade of change and revolution.
What does the future hold for you? The combination of excitement and security in a career can be yours if you prepare for it. If you want to achieve status and get a quality education with definite career goals in mind, Our Lady of Victory Secretarial School will help you find your way in the working world. Our Lady of Victory Secretarial School is registered and fully accredited. Financial aid is available. And to be certain that your career is always secure, we offer lifetime placement service.
I would rather be a graduate of Our Lady of Victory than compete against one, wouldn't you?
On tonight's Fame, an exciting concert performed live at world-famous Jones Beach. A return to the heart of rock and roll.
I'm picking up good vibration. She's giving me excitation. And we'll have fun.
Don't miss the return of the Fame stars to Jones Beach on this special in-concert Fame.
This Sunday at 7 p.m. on Channel 5.
The decade of the 1960s was marred with assassinations, violence, and civil disobedience. Channel 5 viewers, along with the rest of the nation, sat glued to their TV sets during 4 days that forever left an imprint on us all. The days surrounding the assassination of John F. Kennedy. The post-war prosperity of the 50s was a memory. And by the end of the 60s, we were involved in a war in Vietnam that would become unwinnable. The 60s did have its good times, however. Also in November of 63, the Beatles were on their way to America to launch the British invasion. Other groups followed. The Rolling Stones, Herman's Hermits, The Animals, and The Who. Locally, neighborhood bands from Messina to Ticonderoga were imitating those sounds in garages all over the North Country. And if your band was lucky enough, you might have appeared on Actionland 5, hosted by Al Hill.
Direct from the Channel 5 studios, it's Action Land 5.
There you have it. Hey, little girl. Why the novations? Hey, they got a good sound, huh? You like that? Very, very good. Say, from little girl, we're going to talk to the young fellow over here. Because he wrote the next one, right? Jim Santa, right?
Yes.
James, they tell me you wrote our next tune.
Yeah.
What's the title of this little ditty?
I Want Your Girl.
And how long have you had this one out?
About 2 months.
Very good. Let's hear it right now. I Want You Girl.
In September of 1962, WPTZ erected a brand new antenna system that increased our viewing area by 37%. That meant more people could see shows like Flipper. The show star was Brian Kelly, who played Porter Rick, not to mention Flipper, who, by the way, was played by Susie the Dolphin. Another popular show was The Bill Cosby Show, which marked his return to network TV after I Spy left the air. In this show, Bill played a physical education teacher in suburban Los Angeles. No review of the 60s would be complete without mentioning one of the most famous police dramas of all time. It won an Emmy in 1955 for Outstanding Mystery or Intrigue Program and didn't go off the air until 1970. The show is Dragnet, and the star is Jack Webb.
Joe, looks like we struck oil. Donald Chapman, age 31, 662 Tamarack Street, North Hollywood. Fits the description. Out on bail.
For what?
He's waiting trial for ADW.
Yeah, go on.
Involved in a traffic accident, Sunset and La Brea. Locked bumpers with another car. Minor damage. Sounds a little psycho.
Yeah.
The other driver, man named Leroy Wilson.
Well, what about
him? Well, this Chapman jumped out of his car and shot Wilson in the arm. .22 caliber revolver.
Why? Because of the accident?
Not according to the report. Chapman gave another reason.
What's that?
Wilson's a Negro.
By 1965, local TV stations were using videotape more and more to record programs for playback at a later time. Daytime programs in the early days included Hospitality House, which changed its name to For You, Madame, and finally to On the Local Scene. The lady with me in this picture is Marie Baldwin. However, if you were a night owl in the mid-60s, no doubt Chiller Theater curdled your blood late Friday night. No need to be alarmed, however. The man in the vampire costume is Action Land 5's host, Al Hill.
Good night, Clarence. Oh, good boy, good boy. We'll see you next week on Chiller Theater. And to all of you, a most pleasant nightmare. May we see you all next week on Chiller? I hope so. Count the Theater, bidding you all.
When we return, we'll take a look at the recent past, the 70s and the 80s, and we'll also find out where some old familiar faces from the past are today.
That's Jenny. That's not Jenny's dad. Teach your kids not to get into cars with strangers. Help take a bite out of crime.
Look at five. We're bringing the best there is to you. Look at five. Proud to be with you. Look at us. We've come a long way. We're bringing it all to you every day. Look at five, look at WPTZ. Look at five.
I hope you've enjoyed our Chiller presentation as much as we've enjoyed bringing them to you. But for now, we must leave you.
Look at five, look at WPTZ.
By the time the 1970s were launched our way, Americans were seeing themselves in quite a different light. The decade of the 70s would be remembered as the me decade. 1972 saw the re-election of Richard Nixon. 2 years later, he would resign the presidency in disgrace. The terrors of a war in Vietnam were brought home via TV news each evening. There was more news on TV than ever before. A milestone occurred in 1975 when Channel 5 abandoned its film cameras and went solely with videotape to report the day's news. No more waiting 2 hours to process film. Tape was instantaneous. By this time, Channel 5 was producing a news show called Take 5 with Dave Nolan and Steve Herman. The show aired weekly and dealt with timely subjects.
In October 1973, the Oakland A's beat the New York Mets to win the World Series. Gerald Ford wasn't vice president yet, and a gallon of regular gas in upstate New York and Vermont cost an average of 37.9 cents a gallon.
1975 was the year Channel 5 carried the Jerry Lewis Muscular Dystrophy Telethon for the first time. We carried the telethons until 1979. In that year, over $1 million was raised in the viewing area.
The fun starts Sunday night, September the 4th, right here on WPTZ TV. Rolls right on through Labor Day. Be sure to join us. That's right after the Dean Martin special.
Right. Is he going to...
By the mid-70s, Channel 5 was airing its own version of the popular General Electric College Bowl seen on NBC. Bill Everleth acted as the quizmaster.
What was Pegasus? Yes, Franklin.
A winged horse.
A winged horse, 10 points for Franklin Academy.
4 years later, in 1980, Channel 5 reporters got the chance of a lifetime to cover the 13th Winter Olympics in Lake Placid. A series entitled Olympic Countdown, produced by Dave Moses, aired prior to the February Games. Once the games were underway, Channel 5 had nightly reports from a team of reporters covering the day's events from downtown Lake Placid.
We are here tonight to receive the flame as the symbol of all that Lake Placid has worked for more than 20 years.
Dave Moses for NBC News, Lake Placid.
4 years later, in 1984, Channel 5 sent anchorman Chris Ortloff and sportsman Tim Singer to Sarajevo, Yugoslavia, to report back on the efforts of local athletes in the competition for the 14th Winter Olympic gold. By 1976, Channel 5 had outgrown its original home in the McMartin Building, the present site of Marine Midland's West End office, and a search was on to find a new site. After almost a year of looking, ground was broken for its new home just off the Northway at exit 39. By October of 1977, we were moved in. One of the last items to be moved was our news set, including the anchorwoman, Jeannie Mose.
That about does it for this newscast, and that about does it for this station. Our next report will be tomorrow at 11 o'clock from our news station on the old Moffett Road.
In 1979, with its new building and TV's rapidly expanding technology, WPTZ produced and aired a half-hour special entitled The Strike at Dannemora, a critical 2 weeks. The show won a New York State Broadcasters Award for the best local news special. With the advent of cable TV and other competition, TV stations like Channel 5 have produced programs that are local in nature to lure viewers. In 1981, Channel 5 aired On the Road Again, a country music show featuring local talent. '82 was the premier year for four-star bowling, hosted by Jerry Jarvis. The show aired on Sunday mornings and was quite popular with local bowlers.
And it's just a matter of who gets the breaks as to who will win this particular match.
Kelly Grabowski going to open up on the left-hand lane. And you can see some of the avid fans. They have their Go Unis and Bear sign. And if you remember, in that first match, that crowd was pretty loud behind the two of them.
Also in 1982, Channel 5 opened a news bureau in Burlington and had a live anchor person in both Plattsburgh and Burlington. That very first Vermont anchor person, by the way, was Dave Bowman. And just last year, we opened a news bureau serving Ticonderoga, New York, and Rutland, Vermont. And now, as we promised, let's take a look at where some old familiar faces are today.
Memories press between the pages of my mind. Memories sweeten through the ages just like wine.
Everybody, I'm Chet Bosworth. I was here at Channel 5 when we first went on the air back in 1954. In 1956, when the company split, I decided to go with radio. My colleague, Bird Burdan, went with television. And if any one individual personifies the 30 years that Channel 5 has been on the air, entertaining and informing the North Country, it's you, Bird. An anniversary wouldn't be complete without a surprise. And in appreciation to you, Bird Burdan, for being here for 30 years, and a big congratulations to you and Channel 5 for 30 years together.
Wow, that looks yummy, huh, Chet? Like the old days on Hospitality House. Thank you very much. That is beautiful. Thank you, Chet. And thanks to all of you out there. Thanks for tuning us in these past 30 years. It wouldn't have been possible without you. We hope you've enjoyed our anniversary party. My special thanks to Chet Bosworth of Wiry Radio and to all of you. And until we meet again, I'm Bird Burdan.
And I'm Chet Bosworth. Good night.
Look at five. We're bringing the best there is to you. Look at five. Proud to be with you. Look at us, we've come a long way. We're bringing it all to you every day. Look at five, look at WPTZ. Look at five.
Hey. Laundry man.
Alexander.
Look at five. Look at WPTZ.